Hello everybody, today I'm here with the LEGO Jurrassic Park T-Rex Rampage 75936 LEGO set, and I'm gonna build it and look at the features and functions and show you how does the model look at the end. Plus I will as well compare it to the probably second largest dinosaur in LEGO history. So let's take a look in the box, which contains more than 3,000 pieces. So here is the box from the other side, and I'm gonna take a look with you what is actually inside, but it looks and feels kinda full. I had to pause the video because actually I found there's a big box within a box. So here we have the first batch of the numbered bags that were inside the big box, and I'm just gonna open the smaller one to see what is inside. And here we have more numbered bags, and here are the building instructions with the sticker sheet that actually contains just 7 stickers, which is not so bad for a set of such a big size. So I'm gonna open the building instructions and start with bag number 1. Here you can see the finished T-Rex and the Jurassic Park gate. Yeah, it's huge. It's really big and I have trouble fitting it inside my photo tent. Well, actually it's not a problem to fit it inside a photo tent, but it's a problem to show it without as well showing the sides of the photo tent over here. So this is as much as I can show you right now over here. But let's take a closer look at the finished model. First, I'm gonna show you the display for the minifigures, which you can see over here. The stand is quite nice with a tiny velociraptor, even though the plastic plant leaves are actually sometimes just unclipping from the bottom of the plate. But that's my only nitpick, otherwise it looks really, really good. And I'm probably gonna display the minifigures inside the gate, inside their vignettes, which I'm gonna show you as well later on. Here you can see the spare parts, and yes, there's quite a few, and some quite useful. Some of them are even printed. You get as well extra eye for the T-Rex, which is a new print if I'm not mistaken, and some other stuff, and there's plenty of it. And of course you get a teal brick separator. Who doesn't want that, right? But right now I'm gonna show you the main sections of the build. So here is the gate in full glory, showing all the details with the fires over here and all the leaves and foliage down there. I like as well from the details the tracks for the off-road vehicle in the dirt. And you can open and close the gate. It's supposed to open this way, but if you force it a little bit, sometimes the doors just go forwards. Yes, this way, but that's where they tend to stop. Otherwise, the function works really nicely and very smooth thanks to the clever build of the hinges. I'm gonna turn the whole gate over here so you can see how does the function work, and it's operated by three 22 gear wheels that are linked to two bone gears or knob gears on each side, which rotate the gate doors. You have a nest with a broken egg over here. Some more leaf details, and I'm gonna pick up the camera and show you the small vignettes. So here at the bottom you can see the cut hand over here trying to reach the switch. Here you have the control room with the computer screens and the rotary chair. Here is a nice build of the toilet. This is the middle section that controls the opening of the doors, and you can see a nest with broken eggs over here. And there is a secondary platform where you can place any minifigures you want to. So here at the top you have a clip and a piece of plant over here. Right underneath you have a dining room with some food and mint jelly and whatever is this in the bowl. And you can place a minifigure behind the table. And here at the bottom is the most detailed section of the whole, from all the vignettes, with a bed, climbing ladder, some shelves. And here is as well a crate with a camera. Come on, get out. Oh gosh. Yep, and there's as well a fire extinguisher over here. Plus, if you open this locker, there are two weapons hiding behind this wall. So that's all for the details. And here is the highlight of the model, at least for me, which is the finished T-Rex. As you can see, the model is extremely, extremely big. It measures almost 70 centimeters in length. It's very detailed. The build, except for the tail section, is not very repetitive, and it's quite surprising in many places. I have to say I really had fun, and what I do like the most about the T-Rex is, except for the head shape, which is absolutely perfect, it's the posability of it, because the hip joints have some flex in them, So you can slightly move the legs in and out. But it's not difficult to pose the T-Rex at all, just standing on the legs and using the weight of the model. You can as well angle the whole neck section up and down, up to here, basically. That's the highest angle. Oh, okay, one click more. That's the highest angle you can place it at. The head swivels from side to side and slightly rotates. You can open and close the mouth, and you can as well change the angle of the tongue if you want. You can slightly articulate the eyes, but I like to keep them the way they are sitting against the structure over here. You have ball-jointed shoulders, ball-jointed wrists, and as well articulation on both the claws on the front paws. There is no articulation for the hind legs, because you know the model is really heavy and it needs to carry the whole weight. You can though articulate the fingers in and out if you want to, and you can as well articulate the claws over here, which consists of two symmetric builds, which is kind of interesting, but the shape looks really nice. You can articulate these claws as well in the back, and the whole tail is articulated on ball joints, so each of the sections can move from side to side, and the last two sections are on a single ball joint, so they can move as well up and down and from side to side. But overall, I think this just looks gorgeous, and this is definitely going on display. And of course, you know, we should always compare the biggest ones to the other biggest ones. So on the right side we have, I believe it's definitely the biggest dinosaur that was made from System as an official set. And on the left side we have actually the only official dinosaur that was made in LEGO Technic, which has just a little bit modified head, but otherwise I kept it as it is from the instructions, and you can see that they scale quite well, even though of course, yeah, the Technic one lacks a lot of details. On the other hand, it has more features and can do some crazy stuff, because if you haven't seen this set, you can actually program the movements of the T-Rex, so it can open and close the mouth and move the front legs, and afterwards it can as well move the whole body up and down and swing the head and tail from side to side. So you can see how I move the body up and down, and you can as well see the head and section of the tail that is visible in the camera moving from side to side. So yeah, these guys are definitely gonna be sitting close to each other. And here you can see them again side to side. So as you can see, the System one is definitely longer, but the hips of the Technic one are sitting higher, and as well you can move the head thanks to the posability of the body higher than on the System one. That's all from my side. Click like if you enjoyed watching the video, leave a comment if you feel like, and subscribe for more content. Until next time, take care and bye bye.